hello and welcome. I'm Peggy, and I hope you'll take time to just get a comfortable chair and stay with me because I have a very special lady here, and I'm so anxious to have a chance to visit with her, and I hope that you will be also enriched by watching today's program. And my guest is Destiny Yarborough. And she is the executive producer of a TV program, among other things. And she's also an author. And you speak at conferences and travel with a message of hope.
Yes.
And I think if ever we need it, we need it now.
Yes, that's so true. Deliverance and hope, that's our message. That's our ministry. We have a deliverance ministry.
Well, this little book, I wish I'd had it before. I just got it. Visions, Dreams, and Destiny. This is your book.
Yes, ma'am. It's my personal testimony of what I went through to be where I'm at today. And, you know, the Lord has brought me through some trials and tribulations. And, you know, we talked earlier about a purpose. We all have a purpose and walking in our destiny. So the book is titled Visions, Dreams, and Destiny because we are called to be visionaries. We are called to dream dreams, and God wants to fulfill our dreams and have us walk in our destiny, which is our purpose for the kingdom, for Him, for His glory. It's not about us, but for His glory.
And I think many times the young people today are struggling because they don't have a leadership role in front of them in their home.
Yes. That's so good you touched on leadership because you are correct. And a lot of them are just going through the motions of life, but not really knowing that they were designed, they were created for a purpose. And, you know, we cater to a lot of the millennials. I have a 16-year-old son at home. So I feel that God is entrusting us in our ministry to speak into the lives of this next generation and teach them and give them wisdom and nuggets, if you will, of what we've learned and the knowledge that we have, because not a lot of them are exposed to church in the home, you know? And, you know, I'm a believer that children do learn what they live, and we need to instill values and instill in them, you know, that certain things, we don't want to preach, we just have to live it. It's all what you do behind closed doors, living it.
You said it. Just to preach to them doesn't go over.
That's going to actually push them away.
Yeah.
But if we just be with them, and I'm working now around a lot of millennials, the Lord is humorous in that way. He's got me in a position with all these millennials, and it's been an adjustment. I'm going to be honest. It's been a big adjustment. I have to pray every day because they feel like I've been told, let them fall and pick themselves back up. And I'm not used to that in the work environment. I'm used to, if I fall, we fall together. I pick you up. We learn together. So this is all new to me in this new, you know, 2018 year of just, we have to listen and just let them, I guess, make their mistakes, but try to guide them through. Does that make sense? Be a guide for them, if you will.
Yeah, but I don't quite go with that, let them fall and pick themselves up. I don't go with that.
I don't either.
We all had a helping hand.
We all
when
did.
We were young and teenagers, and there was somebody there with that hand to help you up because we all made mistakes.
That's right. That's what we're used to. That's our generation.
I'm sorry. I think it's a good one.
Yeah, I do too. X generation.
Right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So you're saying that now the feeling is that that's not the way to go.
In the work environment, today's what they're training is to let them fall and pick themselves back up. This is all new to me, so it's been a big adjustment for me. And that's just, I'm learning every day being around them. But I know that we need to be able to just listen. I'm having to really listen a lot and then just try to be the example.
But now you have a 16-year-old
I do.
Son right now
in
your home.
Yes.
So maybe you could, how do you manage?
Well, with him.
You say, listen. you know, many times the people will say, well, they don't talk to me.
Yeah, see? Well, that's true. I mean, I have to ask a lot of questions.
Yeah.
And I do ask a lot of questions, you know, how was school, you know, how's your day? He goes to spend the night at someone's house or he's going to do an event with someone, you know, who's going? I ask a lot of questions because I'm still, even though he's 16, he's still my responsibility. And I want to make sure that, you know, he's not getting into something he shouldn't get into.
Yeah, so. But you ask it not in a way like you're, you know, trying to ask it like in a friendly way.
Just a conversation.
Casual.
Mm-hmm. Conversation. Just having a conversation with him.
So that's what parents, I think, could benefit from today.
Yeah.
Is
yeah.
Just a casual way and not have the young person feel like you're drilling them, you
right.
know.
Right.
Because then that turns them off.
Oh, yeah. And even just getting in the car on the way to school in the morning. You know, he's about to start driving. He's saving for his first car, which is great. I'm very
sure.
proud of him. He's already got quite a bit saved.
That's wonderful.
To get the vehicle that he wants. But in the morning, driving him to school, that's our time just to talk and bond. And because with work and school and activities, by the time you get home, have dinner, homework, it's time to go to bed. So take those moments and just cherish those moments and spend that time just having a conversation, even if it's just a 5-minute conversation on the way to school.
I think that's very important.
Yes, ma'am.
And I think we've lost some of that in this generation.
Yeah. Yeah, we have.
Do you agree?
I do. It's a different time. It's a totally different time. Everybody's on their devices. Everybody's on their phones.
Yeah.
Social media. No one wants to pick up the phone and call. Everything is via text.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still old-fashioned in that sense. I like to pick up the phone and have a conversation. You know, how are you? You know, how are you feeling? You know, I think it's a little more personable, but it's just the age that we're living in, and we just have to, you know, sometimes it's just embracing the change because we're in an ever-ending, changing, revolving cycle every day.
Wow. Sometimes it goes too fast.
It does.
Now, you are the producer of a TV program.
Yes, ma'am.
Channel
yes,
57.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
In Atlanta. How did that all come about?
Oh, my goodness. So, thank you for asking that question. So, I had been going on some programs sharing my testimony and about our ministry, and the Lord said, it's time to do your own show. And I said, Lord, I don't have the means to do my own show. I don't know anything about a television show, just like the magazine. But he's been dropping in our spirit, in my spirit, you know, he's called us to the media mountain, and I'm seeing that now from the book to our magazine, now to our television program. And let me tell you, God is just really, really doing a huge thing in our show. We talk about heavy topics that people don't want to talk about. We talk about sex trafficking. We talk about addiction. We talk about suicide. We talk about bullying. We talk about trauma. Choices, and this is for the next generation. So people that are in their age category can come on and speak to that topic.
Wow.
They're going to listen a little more and be in tune. And you never know, that one little nugget could change someone's life. If someone's contemplating suicide or they're cutting, you know, one little nugget could totally change someone's life. So God's got his thumbprint all over this show. We just did our 4 tapings the other day, and they were on bullying, manipulation, trauma. We had someone on there that has a powerful testimony. He's actually a pastor now, and he speaks to the colleges. He's a millennial. He was delivered from homosexuality, sex, drugs and alcohol, and the occult,
mm-hmm.
the occult, amongst other things. So it was just powerful, and I was just sitting back saying, God, like, it was all God.
Do you think that this generation of young people that you're talking about mm-hmm. they're presented with a lot more choices and not good choices than a generation ago?
Oh, absolutely. Times are very different. You turn on the television station, and I mean, it's like back in our day, that would have been considered rated R
yeah.
3 times over.
Yeah.
And it's just normal television. You just turn on the station and what you see, you know. It's definitely a different time. And we can't shelter our children. We cannot. You know, my son was in a private Christian school for up until he was in ninth grade. And we moved him to a public school because he was just too sheltered. And I didn't want to run the risk of course, I prayed about it and I felt that's what the Lord was leading. But I didn't want to run the risk of him getting out in the going to college and going buck wild because he was so sheltered. So he needs to be exposed to different things. We talk to him, we tell him, you know, when you go to a party, somebody pulls out marijuana, what are you going to do? Mm-hmm. I mean, these are questions
this
that
is
we
the
need
thing.
To have.
You want to encourage parents to talk to their kids. And many times these young people today are presented with things that you and I would not have had happen to us.
Right.
Right?
Yes, yes. And we need to talk to our children. If and I want to speak to you and tell you, if your children, if alcohol runs in your bloodline, if suicide runs in your bloodline, these are conversations that you need to be having with your children. Alcohol runs on our side of the family, on my son's biological father's side of the family. We talk to him about alcohol. He knows it takes one sip, that is it, because it's in the bloodline. So, and he knows, so he's going to be a little more cautious if he goes to a party or if he goes somewhere and he knows he's going to already have that in his mind, in the back of his head, that seed's been planted, it takes one sip, that's it. It's important. Mm-hmm. It's important. And it's we're educating our children. We're educating this next generation. We're not scolding and saying you have to do this. We're
it's how you do it.
Teaching and saying, you know, a nugget or, you know, something that you need to know about. Knowledge. Knowledge is power. God's knowledge, of course.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So as Christian parents, you feel that I think many times they hesitate, Christians, to talk about these things because it is a no-no. Mm-hmm. But you've got to be able to open the doors and let your children see what's right out there and warn them. I mean, you would warn your children to look at the light and be sure it's green before you cross the street. Mm-hmm. And it's as simple as that.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes.
We are going to go to a quick break and come back, and I want to talk about this vision, dreams, and destiny. I want to talk about your book. We'll be right back.